Hello, I'm going to do a quick demonstration using x64 debug why a knob is not equal to exchange EAX EAX in 64-bit mode. So everything I say in this video is only valid for the x86 64 architecture and not the x86 32 architecture. And I'll also show some other ways to zero extend the RAX register. When we assemble instructions using x64 debug and we ask it to assemble xchg exchange, EAX, EAX, in both set parse and ASMJIT mode, the actual generated opcode is 90, which is the opcode for the knob instruction. This is actually a wrong implementation. Exchange EAX, EAX should always zero extend EAX into RAX. Let's first demonstrate this using the RBX register. We load any application, let's run Notepad for the purpose of this demonstration. We won't actually run it, we just need a context we can work in. We code the xchg in EBX, EBX instruction. Let's fill RBX with Fs. A quick method to do that is double click the register and type -1. Then we single step over it using F7. Then we see that RBX has been zero extended. Let's now do this for RAX. I will first demonstrate the knob. Simple type the instruction, we encode it. We will fill both the RBX register and the RAX register with Fs. And we will single step over the instruction. And you see, EAX has not been zero extended, because knob is a no operation. We code the xchg EAX EAX instruction. And you can see that the instruction has been encoded as 90, a knob. And we step over it. We see that RAX is still filled with the Fs and has not been zero extended. That's because a knob is really a no operation instruction. Let's encode the exchange EAX EAX instruction manually, as I don't know of any way of doing it correctly in x64 DBG. We right click the RIP register and click follow in dump. Then in the dump we start binary editing and we type the opcode 87CO. This is another way of encoding the xchg EAX EAX instruction. You can go to sandpile.org for the actual technical explanation. When we single step now, we see that this time RAX has been zero extended, exactly what we wanted. The point is, not all assemblers can encode xchg EAX EAX correctly in 64-bit mode. Another way of zero extending is the MOV instruction. There is no MOV ZX RAX EAX compatible encoding. To zero extend, we use the regular MOV instruction. Let's quickly test this. We type MOV EAX EAX and fill RAX with Fs again. Single step, and we see that it has been executed as expected. We fill RAX with Fs. Now there is another unexpected instruction that is capable of doing this. MOV S XD. This instruction is actually used to sign extend a 32-bit register into a 64-bit register. Encoding the 32-bit variant is not supported using the ASMJIT parser. We have to use zparse. When the 64 RAX prefix is removed from the instruction, the target register is actually a 32-bit register on my Intel system. And we single step. We see that EAX has been zero extended instead of sign extend. This might be professor specific behavior. And for the fun of it, let's type the official instruction MOV S XD RAX EAX. Let's test this again. We single step. And behold, RAX is now filled again with Fs. I have demonstrated three methods for zero extending a register. Using xchg, where the EAX variant does not assemble correctly always. The official way using MOV. And an undocumented way using MOV SXD. Take care, fellow reversers. Don't stop learning.